good, wonderful friend from Publishers Weekly, Kevin Brierman. And today we're going to just ask Kevin for his insight to the publishing industry as it has to do with small publishers and mid-sized publishers and their role and changing role in the industry. But before we get on to that, how's the VA been so far?
The VA has been great. I think the attendance is really up. There's a lot of buzz going on. I think for the small and mid-sized publishers, they can get some of the great books out there in front of bookshelves a lot. They're all to purchase and regulate books. I think it's great. It's really the show. It is the place to be if you want to learn about books.
Kevin and I were talking earlier, and we do know that things are changing. And Sterling House is a small publisher, just on the verge of being a mid-sized publisher. And we've gone through a lot of changes, have had our challenges that we have overcome, and there's going to be a lot more challenges ahead of us. But it seems that the role now that we play is a lot more important to the industry than it was, say, 10 years ago.
And I agree with Cindy. I sit on the board of directors for PMA, which represents small and mid-sized publishers. And I think that the future of publishing is mid-sized and small publishers. They have great books, great authors. That no longer see some big houses that are not being discovered. Or mid-sized authors and publishers, but usually if you have even bigger figure because the authors have grown with the industry and they just have to buy it. Growth of publishers, small, mid-sized. When I met Cindy about a year ago when I walked into her office, she was amazed that publishers didn't really have a single.
Which was very true.
And she couldn't believe that somebody from New York would come down and look at her stuff, and she has great stuff. And this is the future of small and mid-sized publishers, a great office who want to do a discovery.
I'll share this with you. We had several people from a very large publishing company stop by, and they asked us if we have a position because we want to be where it's like a family. And the choice is such as Charles Taylor is still buying and their voices are still there. And the front cover package got Charles Perrault, that James Patterson asked Charles Perrault to sign a book for him because he had seen it on the PW, seen him show daily. His face is all over the PEA. What's his fuck? And I was saying,
that's my perfect example of somebody who's small publisher.
And what happened in this circumstance is once Kevin came down and showed interest in small publishers, I kind of picked his brain. Well, I didn't really even have to pick. I didn't have to pick his brain. He was open to everything. He gave me some insight as to how we get things going into the market. And as a result, we took his advice. And now Charles Perrault is, we sold foreign rights translations. We picked up a new foreign rights agent to handle. And not only just Charles, but the entire company because of the visibility of Charles. So to advertise it and do what we did with Publishers Weekly was phenomenal.
It's all about brand and Sterling. It brings a mid-sized publisher an advertising Publishers Weekly, but it's also getting that editorial message with editorial content. Advertising is us made to a certain level, but PW brand yourself in the industry. And we are the B2B or trade magazine, number one in book publishing. But that's the reason why PW wants to help the mid-sized and small publishers. So you guys go, I believe that's the future of publishing and mid-sized.
Well, again, thank you very much.